Hey guys, welcome to another video. My name is Ronald, I'm from 360 Traders, and in this video I'm going to talk about getting content inside your 3dvista project, and especially focus more on e-commerce and virtual stores and embedding content from stores that do not allow to be embedded. What does that mean? Well, let's say over here I have this website and I'm looking at the store and I'm like, oh cool, I'm just going to grab this URL and put that inside my 3dvista project. And so I'll just preview this and then refuse to connect, right? This is something that happens a lot in e-commerce, and that makes it pretty challenging to make a virtual tour about all the content from the store. There's something inside Airtable, and that is called the web clipper. What I've already done is I've set up a very simple table with name, nodes, price, link, attachments, and ID. And what I would like to do here is to fill up this whole Airtable with a bunch of items from the store, in this case from Wim Hof, where he's selling all these t-shirts, and being able to use them inside the 3dvista tour with the links to all these product pages so that people can buy them. And that could be a referral link so that you can track how many are coming from the virtual tour, get your affiliated commissions and stuff like that. So this is a way to make either passive money this way for virtual stores or whatever you come up with as a virtual tour crib. The same principles that I'm going to show you here, this is with a store that is custom built, but you can do the same with IKEA pages. So if you want to have this couch inside the Airtable with the price and the title, then you can get all those things there as well. Same with Amazon products, same with Coolblue if you're from the Netherlands. Shopify stores. So any type of website on the internet, you can get all the content relatively easy inside Airtable. And an easier way will be to just export and import everything from the store owner, obviously. But for whatever reason, you might not have access to it, you could start using the web clipper. In Airtable, you can use extensions. Now, extensions are possible with the pro plan of Airtable, so you need to pay like a monthly subscription for that. But if you just start it for 1 month and cancel it right away after you've added your stuff into it, you're all good and you can continue with free plans. So I'm going to add an extension. Search for web clipper. I add it. And so here it's saying, okay, title of clip action, add direct to Wim Hof to this table. Sure. Add extension. So here I can start saying, okay, the name from the page title, link from the page URL, attachments. Let's do here the social media image and notes. I'm not sure. So let's just click done here and see what happens. I'm going to the store. You are the alchemist. And what we're going to do is we click on the web clipper, add to Wim Hof. And as you can see, I'm already getting the title and the name field, the link from this product page, and the image, the first image, right inside the attachment field. Only the notes are missing. So this is how you can get a specific part of the whole thing. So now I would like to get this part, right? So I say inspect. And then over here, I just right click, copy. Copy selector. Then we go over here, notes, and then we say over here, text content by CSS selector. All right, paste, hit done, go back, refresh the page just in case, and then add to Wim Hof. Let's see, and now we have also the text over here. So that's great. The same applies if we want to get whatever this tag, for whatever reason, you can just right click it, get a little down inside here, and you can play around where in the tree you need to do this, but you can just say copy selector. So this applies to these things, applies to different types of descriptions. So if you want this description or that description, you can all organize them into your own fields. Right now we've got what we need, so that's great. So let's say add bracket. So we go over to Airtable and we can see it's over there. The only thing that's missing here is the price. So let's get the price as well. We go over here, right click, inspect. Let's get it with the euro sign. Copy, selector, go over here. Now here we need to add an extra field. So we already have those four, but we're missing the price field. We'll do a CSS selector and we paste this inside. Click done. Now let's just remove this bracket and try it again. Clipper, add to Wim Hof. And now we also have the price. So that's great. Add record. And we can see in Airtable, we have all of these fields filled in and organized nicely. So that's great. Now, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to collect a few more t-shirts. All right, add. You can see how fast I'm doing this, right? It's really that simple now. All right, so I've added four products to it. Now the IDs are a little bit different. I'm using auto fields number here, auto number. I'll just quickly reset that, putting this to a single text and putting this back to an auto number so that they start counting at one again. So I've already connected Skin CMS with the project. So the only thing I need to do is now connect the Alchemy hoodie to 3dvista. So I'm going to the panoramas, hotspots. I have like this rollover effect. So when rolling over this one, then it toggles like this. On this thing, I have to click actually to show the components and the product pop-up. Now I need to add this JavaScript action. So say one. Copy, paste, change the number. Done. All right. Done. Let's preview this. So you can see that we have the hotspots. We click on number one and we see Alchemy hoodie. All right. As you can see, I put in the price inside the text button. I don't know if it makes sense like this. Maybe I should make it a formula and say buy for 48 euros or the 48 euros elsewhere. But right now, so, and when I click on the button, it opens up and I can go over to another one. And here I could put in my affiliate links instead. So you can see the result of the virtual tour compared to all the other sales that are already happening. All right. I hope you've learned something in this video and that you found this stuff helpful. If you like to continue, if you like what you see and you want to get started with Skin CMS, you can go to skincms.com/pricing and you can buy mappings. Now, if you have up to like 25 products, for example, 25 t-shirts to sell, then the small mapping is more than enough for your project. If you have more than that, you are going to need the standard mapping up to 100 records. And if you need even more than that, you can just contact us. So yeah, thanks for watching. Have a great day. Like the video, subscribe, and register for our newsletter on 360grids.com/newsletter. And have a great day. All right. See ya. Bye-bye.